my name is Debbie Brock, and I am the founder of Homeopathy World Community. And today we're going to be talking to the Drs. Banerji, and you'll have to help me with your first names, who have come from India all the way to Buffalo, New York, to speak to a very large group of homeopaths and other health professionals to teach about their protocols.
And as we have working jointly with my son, and we attend in our clinic more than 1,000 patients a day, and we have made some observations and protocols, which is known now all over the world as the Banerji protocol of medicines. And we are doing a lot of research works, and a lot of research works are being done in USA with the collaboration of the most famous institutes like MD Anderson Cancer Center, like National Cancer Institute of USA. Then we like to make homeopathy popular and scientifically established throughout the world.
Well, you know, I have a question. You say that you see 1,000 patients per
day.
Yeah. That is unfathomable for me. So how many professional physicians, their MD homeopaths, are looking at these, treating these people?
Yes, we have got qualified homeopaths in Calcutta who are looking after this. Prateep, my son, myself. We have got another 14 doctors. We jointly see all these cases. And we have made an institute of homeopathy in there.
It's well recognized by the government.
Yes, well recognized by the government, and our research also is recognized by our government.
By the United States government as
well. United States government as well.
But we never hear about it. The general population does not hear about your work and the possibility that homeopathy is a not only curative, helpful form of medicine. So how are we going to? You're doing a lot of traveling.
And homeopathy is a complete treatment. It is not an alternative treatment. It is a complete treatment. Independently, it can cure diseases. And in India, homeopathy is fully recognized by our central government as a normal stream treatment process.
I'm going to ask you another. It's kind of a controversial question because, in essence, I know places like the UK, we're not really even allowed to say what you just said.
In UK, it is fully recognized by the UK government. It is under the national scheme. The Queen of England and the royal family has their homeopaths and treated in England. It is speaking. Because you see, when we are doing homeopathy, we search for everything good in this world. We try to know the conventional treatment. We try to know what are happening in the world. But very sorry that conventional people, they don't like to know these things. They should inquire these things. They should like to know what is homeopathy, if it's really doing good or not. We have done these works in MD Anderson Cancer Center, and the research works that have been published internationally. After that also, if they say it's not good, lack of knowledge.
Do you want to say something?
I'm Prateep Banerji. I'm the fourth generation homeopath in my family, and we have been in homeopathy for the last 150 years, our family.
Let me hold it for you.
It's okay.
Here you go.
So, we've been in homeopathy for the last 150 years, and we find that homeopathy is an excellent treatment form and a very comprehensive treatment form. It is not that what can be treated with homeopathy. It is homeopathy can treat everything, and we routinely use this system of treatment in our clinics in Kolkata to treat maybe 1,000 to 1,200 cases every day, of which about 100 to 150 to 200 cases of cancer visit our clinic every day. Homeopathy came into our family in 1864 approximately, and we don't do anything other than homeopathy in our clinics. We are, with the help of, say, 13, 14 assistant doctors, we cater to the needs of all these patients.
You learned a great deal from your patients over the history of the many years that you have been doing this practice.
Yes, you know, actually, medicine as is taught in the textbooks is just to start the thought process about health in the doctor. The main teacher of the doctor is usually the patient. Because patients teach us what works, what doesn't work, and how to treat much better, because medicine is a science of experience, right? Mm-hmm. So having experience to treat patients comes only from treating more patients.
Right. So,
and the patients are our greatest teacher.
Right. Many people say that homeopathy is not scientific, but as far as I'm concerned, collecting thousands of cases of data, when you collate all of that information, that really is very scientific. And that's really proof that it's working. So you cannot refute that information, really, when you're seeing people getting healed. And sometimes you said people don't come back when they're healed because they don't feel like they need to see you anymore, and then other people will continue. And one of the things that I noticed from the treatment protocols that you were providing for the practitioners here was that you would be recommending to give a remedy for a long term, for an ongoing basis, let's say for weeks, months, or even years.
So, see, basically the way we practice homeopathy is different from the classical homeopathy.
Okay.
And this has been named internationally to be the Banerji protocols. What we do here is we use homeopathy in a diagnostic way. We treat diseases. We are not stuck onto the classical homeopathic path, where a patient is considered as a whole and a case taking is done, which may be extending to 1 or 2 hours, and they come up with one remedy. That is not the way we do homeopathy. We have changed homeopathy in a way that is much more progressive. We use conventional tools. Conventional means modern medical tools for diagnosis. And we diagnose the patient on the patient's disease, which is not usually done by the classical homeopaths. So we find out the disease, we give a basic medicine to treat the disease, and also adjunct medicines are given to help the patient get relief. Like we palliate the symptoms of the patient, like pain or any discomfort the patient is experiencing, to improve the quality of life. And alongside with that, the actual medicine, that is to treat the disease condition that is present in the patient. So mm-hmm. this is how we have changed homeopathy so many years now.
And in the presentation, you showed us many, many slides of MRIs and CT scans and other organs to show the progression of a disease, where they came in at stage 3, stage 4 of a cancer or some kind of illness. And then over the period of time, you actually kept a track of each patient to see the regression of the disease as proof.
Yes, actually what we do is we have to validate our data scientifically. You know, homeopathy must stand up for examination. Homeopathy must stand up for verification. We must have reproducibility in homeopathy. Because if you don't do all these things, then how can you blame the conventional scientific community if they don't accept you? Because you won't stand up for verification, and yet you will say that, look, they are not giving me the due respect. But at the same time, you have to remember that you have to earn that respect. First, you have to earn that acceptance by showing them, yes, this is scientific. This is not some mumbo-jumbo. This is not some hocus-pocus voodoo.
It really
is a very, very scientific method of treatment. And the action of the medicines is measurable. We can see a tumor that is 8 centimeters big. It gradually becomes 6 centimeters, becomes 4 centimeters, disappears. So all these things need to be put up and for the scientific community to verify. And that is when acceptance will come. That is when homeopathy will take its rightful position as a mainstream medicine.
So basically, we're speaking their language.
Because you must understand that there's actually one language.
Okay.
The problem is the interpretation of it. Because if you want to go out in society, you have to conform to society. You can go and live in a jungle, there's no problem. There are no rules for you then.
Mm-hmm.
But even then, there are rules, because there are other animals in the jungle. But if you live in a city, you have to conform to the rules and regulations of the city. You have to obey the rules of the road. You can't walk in the middle of the road and not expect to be hit by a car. So, to an extent, we have to live within some boundaries. That is discipline. So, if we hope to achieve a status that is at par with conventional medicine, then we must compare up to them. We must be judged by the same tools that they judge each other. And
right. What
is the problem? We can do it.
Well, based on what you've presented, we're showing in their scientific terms with their clinical laboratory definitions and numbers that it works, and even it works even better than what they have to offer, because in many instances, like you mentioned, disease like Alzheimer's, they really have nothing. And you mentioned a good number of diseases where allopathy and today conventional medicine has very little to offer in terms of regression. You were showing things that were unbelievable.
So, if it is like that, if it is that, it's not unbelievable really, because when you come up for verification, you have to produce your best cases, you have to let them see what is happening, and those are not the only cases, because we treat so many cases that we can keep producing cases like this every day, because at some point or the other, somebody is getting well, somebody is getting worse, somebody is static. Homeopathy needs to move forward. Homeopaths need to open up their minds more. Unless the homeopaths open up their mind and move forward, how will you meet the conventional medicine halfway?
I want to thank you for talking with me today.